गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस द कंपनी फॉर्म ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस द मीनिंग फीचर्स मेरिट्स एंड डीमेरिट्स. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टाइप ऑफ कंपनीज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ऑनरशिप. अ कंपनी कैन बी डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री पार्ट्स, प्राइवेट कंपनी, पब्लिक कंपनी एंड वन पर्सन कंपनी. फर्स्ट इज प्राइवेट कंपनी. अ प्राइवेट कंपनी इज डिफाइंड एज अ कंपनी which restrict the right to transfer its shares, has a minimum of 2 and maximum of 200 members, including the present and past employees, does not invite public to subscribe its securities, and it is necessary to use the word private limited after its name. As compared to a public company, a private company is given some exemptions or privileges. These privileges are, first, easy formation. A private company can be started with just 2 members, whereas a public company requires at least 7 members. Second, no need to issue prospectus. There is no need to issue a prospectus as public is not invited to subscribe to the shares of a private company. Third is allotment of shares. It can allot shares and raise capital privately. There is no need to issue prospectus. No need of minimum subscription also. Fourth, starting a business. It can start the business as soon as it is incorporated. Board of directors. It can work with just 2 directors as compared to 3 directors under public company. And maximum number of directors is 15 in private as well as in public companies. Next, not required to keep an index of members. A private company is not required to keep an index of members, while the same is necessary in case of public company. So these are the privileges of private company. Second, public company. What is the meaning of public company? As per Companies Act 2013, a public company is a company which is not a private company. In other words, you can say that it has no restriction on the right of members to transfer the shares, has a minimum of 7 members and maximum no limit, and permits to make any invitation to public to subscribe to its shares and debentures. A private company which is a subsidiary of a public company is also treated as a public company. Third is one person company. What is the meaning of one person company? One person company is also known as OPC. OPC means a company with only one person as its members. So it is incorporated as a private company which has only one member. The aim of introduction of OPC was to encourage the entrepreneurship in India. In the year 2005, the J.J. Irani Expert Committee recommended the formation of one-person company. One-person company avails all the benefits of a private limited company, such as separate legal entity, limited liability and perpetual succession. So now, we have discussed the 3 types of company: public company, private company and one-person company. Now we will discuss the difference between the public company and private company. On the basis of number of members, in public company, it requires minimum of 7 members and maximum unlimited. But in private company, it requires minimum 2 members and maximum 200. On the basis of minimum number of directors, public company must have at least 3 directors. But private company must have at least 2 directors. Third is index of members. It is compulsory to maintain index of members in public company, but it is not compulsory to maintain in private company. Fourth, transfer of shares. In public company, there is no restriction on transfer of shares, but in private company, there is restriction on transfer of shares. Next is invitation to public. Public company can invite public to subscribe its shares, but private company cannot invite public to subscribe its shares. So this is the difference between public company and private company. After studying various forms of business organization, you must have been thinking that each form of organization has its merits as well as limitations. So which form of organization is to be chosen? So here are some factors which are to be considered while choosing a suitable form of business organization. So these factors are: first, cost and ease in setting up the organization. The first and foremost consideration selecting the form of organization is the ease and cost with which it can be formed. In sole proprietorship and partnership are the most inexpensive form of organization and having less legal formalities. In cooperative societies and companies, the registration is very much compulsory. Formation of the company is very complex task. So, according to this consideration, sole proprietorship is the preferred form. Second, liability. In sole proprietorship and partnership, the owner or the partners have unlimited liability. In joint Hindu family business, only the karta has unlimited liability. In case of cooperative society and company, the members have limited liability. So, from the side of investors, company form of organization is more suitable as the risk involved is limited. Third, continuity. An ideal form of organization should ensure the continuity of the business, but there is lack of continuity in the sole proprietorship and partnership. So, if the business is intended for a longer period of time, company or cooperative society form of organizations are more suitable. Fourth, managerial ability. The nature of operations and the need for personalized management also affect the choice of form of organization. A sole proprietor may find it difficult to have expertise in all functional areas of management. Under partnership, cooperative societies and companies, division of work is possible. If operations of the organization are complex and require personalized management, then company form is better alternative. In case of simplicity of operations, proprietorship and the partnership may be suitable. Fifth is capital consideration. Finance is the basic requirement of any business operation. So, if the business requires huge capital, it should be organized as a company or cooperative society. For medium and small sized business, partnership or sole proprietorship may be chosen. Sixth, degree of control. The choice of form of organization also depends on the degree of control desired. If direct control over operations and decision making is required, then proprietorship is more preferred. But if the owners are ready to share control and decision making, then partnership and company form can be adopted. Next is nature of business. The nature of business is also considered while selecting a suitable form of business organization. If direct personal contact is needed with customers, then sole proprietorship is preferred. Whereas professional services are required, then partnership is more suitable. For large business units where personal attention is not much required, company form of organization is more suitable. So these are the factors which are to be considered while choosing a suitable form of business organization. So this chapter has been completed now. I have uploaded one more assignment which is based on this topic. Do it and submit your all assignments by tomorrow, that is 10th May, on Google Classroom as directed. All the best. Thank you.